really? My 50th review already? It's a milestone. Guess I better pull out all the stops, bring out the big guns, and hold nothing back. War for Cybertron Soundwave is on the slate. And to my fellow YouTubers, Matt360UK, Skibones100, Damn You Hussies, T2RX6, and Golgotha02, thank you for subscribing to me. So on this momentous occasion, on this day of days, this review was requested by Mega TF Man, who hails from the land down under, asking me if I could just review Soundwave anything. So me being the nice guy that I am and all, I didn't want to crush the dreams of an impressionable youth, and I reached into my Soundwave drawer that I got at home and came out with the War for Cybertron mold. This is, without a doubt, one of the heavy hitters coming out of generations. An awesome piece of plastic that belongs in your top five. And if you don't like them, well, I'm sorry, there's just something wrong with you. No, I don't want to hear what your opinion is. It is obviously invalid and doesn't belong here. Go get your head checked and then come back and share in the love, which is War for Cybertron Soundwave. This combination of armored car and wheat harvester is a hell of a sight prettier than any lamppost. And holy hell, you talk about reinventing the wheel! No Earth-based style tires for Soundwave this time around. Nope, right now Satan's wondering who took the demonic six-eyed gears off his Dragula. Sculpted detail is a bit scarce though. There is something going on from all sides at all times, but nothing that'll really draw your eye's attention. At least his color scheme remains true blue, and gray, and Dayglo purple, and gold, and Decepticon emblem. Ah, one of the more iconic features of Soundwave, isn't it? That little door has more mystery behind it than the opening sequence of Rod Serling's Twilight Zone. During any given episode of G1, for instance, Soundwave had more storage capacity in his chest than a hard drive with a terabyte of memory. So you give the Dr. Claw homage a push, chest springs forthright, and hey, weapons! Those battery-centric styled weapons of Soundwaves are a distinguishable part of the character's uniqueness and iconography. So take a guess then, how awesome is it that those same weapons have been faithfully recreated for the current generation? If you said anything from awesome to the max, to not awesome enough, you're getting close. You know, it's one thing to be a great character. It's entirely another when it's your face that inspires the symbol for a faction of evil robots for generations to come. You know, I don't mean to be presumptuous or anything, but I can safely say on behalf of all Transformers fans everywhere that this big hunk of blue cheese definitely wins the space race in high fidelity by a country mile. Even with extra roof rack kibble on his moonwalkers and Todd McFarlane shoulder pads, Soundwave's still superior. The one thing you truly could lament is no Cassetticons for Soundwave. Yeah, there are options to remedy this situation, but it just would have been nice if it was addressed the first time around. Haztac is always teasing us like this, but do they ever pull through and deliver? Nope. Always the block. Damn it! But you know, what Soundwave lacks in minions, he more than makes up for in excellent articulation. He does everything you hope a Decepticon would. He can shake his fist angrily, curb stomp,
take that you stupid. Yeah, welcome to Ponyville, f***. Out of boom.
Or even hightail it out of there when the going gets tough. And now that it's all said and done, old Soundwave is basically everything I look for in a Transformers toy. He's a platinum-plated A+. But lest I forget and be inundated with a bunch of messages, the fun with Soundwave doesn't even stop there. And when you're one of the more iconic Transformers with an even more iconic alt mode, well, the world has a tendency to beat a path to your door. GameStop found a way to do it, and so did eventually the fans, who came up with Fan Mode Boom Box War for Cybertron Soundwave. That was a lot to say. But you know what? Why stop there? I've gone further than I ever have before now. So I think it's only right that I end this in spectacular fashion. Testing! Testing! 1, 2, 3! This is to any Transformers fan within the sound of my voice. Listen to me come through their speakers of their War for Cybertron Soundwave. It's been a hell of a ride up to this point. These past 50 episodes have been a dream come true. I've done things I never thought were possible before. Met people I never knew were out there. Made friends for life. To all of you listening right now, this goes out to you.